Let every heart prepare him room. And a heaven and nature sing, and as we come to worship and sing and celebrate on this wonderful Christmas morning, to celebrate the birth of Christ, I want to welcome you, the First United Methodist Church, Colleen, especially if you're a guest here with us. This will be a fabulous day of worshiping. Let's go to God in prayer. God, we give you again thanks and praise for the wonderful gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, that we celebrate this morning. May our hearts be filled with joy as we sing forth the praise of heaven and nature. God, for joy to the Lord, our Lord has come. We have experienced the dawn of redeeming grace. And so may we make room in our hearts for the joy and the hope, peace and the love that came down in Christmas. Amen.
Thank you.
discipleship, and it has lots of things. Please take it with you, because it has all the enhanced things that are happening this week, but it has about this happening throughout the year. And if you know somebody who's missing today, we have some extras out in the Welcome Center. Take one, so people can have it and just be involved in growing in their discipleship. And I think we even put pumpkin patch in there. Well, we did. And next year is Advent. See, I mean, we're, so you'll know when to show up next year for Christmas Eve. And for your devotional, the upper rooms are available, the January, February edition out in the Welcome Center. And we have some wonderful magnets that concentrate on the children and youth ministries for you on that. A couple of other things, these beautiful poinsettias. If you have provided poinsettias, you are welcome to take that with you after worship today. Or if you don't get a chance, please come in this week. We want you to be able to enjoy that. So you can take a poinsettia home. And then a confirmation class is going to be coming up. Confirmation class will be starting on January 8th. Did I get that right? I got that right. Awesome. At 4 o'clock. Okay, confirmation is for you. For people that were baptized as an infant and now they want to make that confession of faith. And next Sunday, I hope to see you again at 10 o'clock. We're doing another one worship at 10 o'clock next Sunday for New Year's Day. And we're going to do something different with the sermon. It's going to be what's called a brown bag sermon. There is a person that is selected to be given the gift, and then you bring an object in, and I get that object, and I have to do a sermon on that object. Okay? And if I can tie in scripture, the staff parish and the finance have said I'll get $1 million bonus, so I'm really excited. But I have to give $2 million to the church, so it worked out well. So we're trying to think, and we're having all kinds of brainstorming sessions, but we wanted to go with the most, we didn't say ugly, Christmas sweater. We just said most unique, or most outstanding, or most visible, and we all agreed that very hybrid was with that.
Thank you. bringing good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord.
Glory
to
God in the highest, and on earth peace among those whom God favors. Amen.
And now for this joyous singing will come on these faithful.
Thank you.
love of others. And so some of you know what we do with Tootsie Rolls around here, right? You get it? That's exactly right. We keep one, but we get two, because the other one we have to give to someone. And what do we do? What do we tell them? Jesus loves you. That's exactly right. So, but before we do that, let's say a prayer. Whatever we have to be, let it run.
Thank you so much
for the gift of Jesus.
We will pray for Stephen William that he may grow as
We ask that you would fill this water and Stephen who received it, however he serves, that he may be filled with your spirit and he may be the life of your grace that flows freely and amazingly in his life. We ask that that grace, the knowledge of your grace, would grow in his life and he would grow in his life. That he would continue to learn to love you and your people more as you move. We ask in Christ's name.
Stephen, what a special day this is. We have some things for you. This hand or your scarf reminding you of this day and a special certificate. And then this special Bible for you to remember this day and commemorate this day. And as we accomplish the journey in discipleship with you, and I think it's okay to give Stephen Wynn.
Please come forward as we worship God with our gifts and tithes. Our scripture this morning comes from Matthew 2, verses 1, 2, and 11. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in the territory of Judea during the rule of King Herod, Magi came from the east to Jerusalem. Then asked, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We've seen his star in the east and we've come to honor him." They entered the house and saw the child with Mary his mother. Falling to their knees, they honored him. They opened gifts of treasure chests and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Let's pray. God, our provider, we marvel that you care for each individual person. Thank you for giving Joseph dreams for guidance and a trusting heart to follow you. May we take action swiftly in response to your call to compassion for people in need. We dedicate our gifts and tithes in the name of Jesus. Amen.
As we go to God in prayer this morning, if you want to come forward and stand at the altar, you're always welcome to do so. And if you're one of those who likes to pray with your eyes open, I invite you to do that, whatever your favorite prayer posture is. Let's go to God in prayer. We're going to end our prayer with the Lord's Prayer. If you're not sure of the words, just please look on the screen as we say that to you. Go to God in prayer. God, on this marvelous day, we probably just give you thanks and praise for all that this day means. God, and much of what it means, we still don't comprehend. For we know that it is more magnificent than our understanding in what you have done. And so, God, on this day, let us take time to thank you for all the gifts that you give to us in our life. We pray for your great gift of love. And so, God, we pray that you would help us show that love to the right person this week that specifically needs to know, God, of your unconditional, non-judgmental love that you have for each and every person. You have given us the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, but you also called us to pass that gift on to us. So may this day be one of sharing Christ's love with each one we meet. And God, because Christ came into this world to change the world, transform the world, give us the power of the Holy Spirit to have the courage to speak out against injustice and oppression. God, to speak out against things that are against your will in this world. When people are not treated as your people. And God, lead us as one together in this worship. We pray the prayer that your Son Jesus Christ taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem, the territory of Judea, during the rule of King Herod, Magi came from the east to Jerusalem, and they asked, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We've seen his star in the east, and we've come to honor him." When King Herod heard this, he was troubled, and everyone in Jerusalem was troubled with him. He gathered all the chief priests and the legal experts, and then asked them where Christ was to be born. And they said, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for this is what the prophet wrote: 'You Bethlehem, land of Judah, by no means are you the least among the rulers of Judah, because from you will come the one who governs, who will shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the Magi and found out from them the time the star had first appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search carefully for the child. And when you found him, report to me so that I too may go and honor him." And when they heard the king, they went and looked, and the star that they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stood over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house, and they saw the child with a hand. And falling to their knees, they honored him. Then they opened their treasure chest and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, because they were warned in a dream not to return to Herod. They went back to their own country by another route. Word of God, the people come. So as we continue our sermon series talking about these gifts that come at Christmas, and I'm reminded of the services even last night, and some of you were here for the 5 o'clock service, where we thought that the best gift we can give Jesus is in fact not her picture. But who every single gift that she gets, and it's her favoriteest, bestest, most beloved gift ever. Do you know this person? Like every single thing. They are so excited, so filled with joy, that it is the best gift ever. Can you hear them squealing right now? Now this is a response to Christmas. Here's the thing, I don't see this person in our story. Now here's why, because sometimes that person, they get so excited, they might love that gift, they really want it. And then they carry it around with them all day long, or even all week, or maybe even all month. But then something new and bright and shiny comes along, that next gift, that next new thing, and that becomes their favorite, bestest, most shiny, most fantastic gift ever. You know what I'm talking about? You know that person? This is one response we may have at Christmas, and I don't see it in this Christmas story. You know why I think we don't see it in that Christmas story? God is changing. It doesn't change anything. Their lives were not changed. They didn't share this gift with anyone else. It may have excited them for just that little bit. They held on to it, and then it just kind of gets pushed aside into a pile of all those favorite toys ever that are now forgotten and neglected. And that is a response that we can have to the gift of Jesus, too. Christmas is beautiful. If you were here last night, and the candlelight, and the kids singing, it's exciting. It's bright. It's shining. Christmas carols, oh my Lord, I had no idea you all had such beautiful voices. But the bright and shiny universe wants sometimes, right? Then we have the birth of Jesus, and it's wonderful and delightful, but then we hear the teachings of Jesus, and they're challenging. They ask us to do things that are hard sometimes, and then there's this whole cross thing that happens at Easter, and it's not bright, and it's not shining. And so for some, this is a response. We may be really excited by now, and it's our favorite thing ever, and we're really excited, and we're all about Jesus right now. But what happens when it's not as near, and it's not as bright, and it's not as shining? This is our response to the gift of Jesus at Christmas. Or then there is the collector. I got some of these in my family. The collector. And the collectors. Now, they have all the coolest toys, right? They have the best stuff. They can tell you all about it. They know all the details, but they never take it out of the package, right? They never play with it, because that would devalue it in some way. It might make it messy, it might get messed up. We're going to leave it up in the top shelf, that glass shelf. If we do anything with it, we will dust it, right? We'll tell you all about it. Let me tell you the details on this gift. Let me tell you the details on this holiday party. Let me tell you the details on this collector's Hot Wheel, right? We have these people. Don't take it out of the package. Don't mess it up. Now, I do see these people in our Christmas story. And it kind of pains me to say that it's the chief priests and the legal experts, right? Because they know their stuff, they have their stuff, they know their faith, they know the stories of their faith, they know the laws, they know the rules, they follow them, they can share them with anyone who wants to hear about them. And they will hold them up and admire them and hold everyone else to them. But do they ever really get to the essence of it? Do they ever get to that whole part where they talk about So you see, what I hope and what I pray is that not only will this be like the fad, the toy for right now, for today, for this week, or for this month, like what I hope is that in a few years I get to be, right? And then a few more years, he's gonna like be in the band and the jazz band, and he's gonna keep up with those drums. And then when he's a young adult, that he is gonna be up here playing a praise team somewhere in church every Sunday and sharing that gift. That's what I hope. And then I'll be my brother. That's what I hope. Because you see, there's something about that. That response that brings so much joy that you gotta hold on to it. Something about that response that brings so much joy that you gotta share it with others. I mean, it wasn't enough just to play it, it's important for everyone to see this gift. There's something about that response that is life changing, especially if he does end up in that praise team one day. Here it is. today or the gift of this week, but the gift of a lifetime will be life-changing, but it will be transformational. And we love you, want to share. And friends, if you are willing for a community in which to share its most amazing gift, I invite you to share it with the members of your church, please. If you're looking to make an official commitment here, I invite you to take a How to Join form. It's going to invite you to, the member of our church is going to invite you to hear if you have come back to us yet. We're very excited that you have a new member in Christ this morning. And so I invite you to fill those forms out so that you can come back to us yet. So we would just get
Spirit. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.